Dear students, today we will discuss about a concept called as union in C. Last session we were discussing about one of the major concept called as structures in C, and today we will see about union, that is almost similar to the structure concept, but there are some differences. Then it is also used for creating a record like structure, like having means employee information or student information, or for storing different types of data under a single structure variable. So that is the purpose, that is almost similar to the same structure concept itself, but union having some drawbacks also. So normally, when compared to structure, we are not commonly using the concept of union. But still, we need to have a comparison between structure and union, and we'll see some simple examples related to union that indicates the differences between structures and union. So, first of all, what is actually a union? It is also a user-defined type. It is also a user-defined type similar to structure. Similar to struct in C programming. Okay, so it also wishes to store different types of data under a single structure name, and different data like string, that is character array, or integer, float, etc. All these categories of data can be held within the single structure variable under a single structure data type. Similarly, under a single union, we can have all these different types of variables permitted. Okay, so it is also like a record type architecture or record type structure only, but let us see the differences. First of all, when we are using union, so we'll see what are the differences when we are using union. First thing is, in the place of struct in structure, we are using another keyword called as union for creating a structure like union. Okay, so it is used, the union is used for, union keyword is used for defining a union. So hereafter I'll be using union, not structures. Structure, I was indicating structure like we are having a record like structure, that's what I was meaning. So when a union is defined, it creates user defined type similar to structure, but no memory will be allocated, that also similar to structure. A structure also, when we are declaring structure variable, then only we are having the allocation of memory. Okay, so let us see the basic syntax of how to create a union. The syntax seems to be almost similar to the structure itself. Union keyword, then the name of union, any user defined name can be given, opening curly bracket, then we are having the data type, then the here we are having a character array which is called as name with 30 as maximum size. Then we are having the data type int. Then we are having age and double salary. So three different types, one character, one integer, and one double types are defined within the employee union. Okay, so finally, that must be ended with a, so semicolon is missing here, so it must be ended with a semicolon here also. So this is the basic syntax of creating a union, almost similar to structure. I think it is clear for you. Okay, now after the creation of union, similar to structure, we need to create a union variable. So how to create a union variable? It is also similar to creation of a structure variable. There it was struct employee S1, S2 like that. Here union employee E for creating a single employee union. Union employee. So these things are almost similar. Only thing is the different keyword, that is called as union. Okay. So this is the basic syntax. So we have to create the data type first. Then we need to create variables based on this particular union data type. Okay. Now we will see the difference between the two, structure and union. What are the basic differences between structure and union? Okay, it's a very important portion. So first thing is here for creating structure we are using struct keyword, but for union we are using union. That is a basic difference. Second point is the members do not share memory in the structure. So you might be remembering, if you are creating a structure for like structure employee, each members, each elements are stored in different location. They are not sharing memory. Each member will be having a separate memory being allocated. Listen carefully. For example, for roll number, for name, for mark, etc., etc., will be having different memory. They are not sharing the memory. Different memories are given. But in the case of union, memory is being shared by the members. That means if you are having some 5 members in union, only a single memory will be allocated at a time. That is for, see, 5 elements are there, 5 members are there, but at a time the memory will be allocated for only one member. For example, some situation it is for roll number, then after the usage of roll number it will be changed to like it is used for name. So only one memory will be allocated, and that one memory size will be the largest among these 5. If you are having 5 elements present, the size allocated for storing these elements are maximum. That depends on the largest data type that is present in this particular union. So that much size will be allocated. But at a time, if you are roll number, next time name or mark, at a time only one data can be held in this particular memory location. That means all the elements are sharing the same memory. But in the case of structure, for individual elements, they are given different memory. I hope it is clear. When we look at examples, we will see those problems. Okay. Now, any member can be retrieved at any time in a structure. So if you are that means that is in relation with the second property only. Now if you are having different memory being allocated for different elements, so from these different memory allocation, any members can be retrieved at any time. At any time, parallelly or at any time, we can retrieve any member from this structure. But the problem with union is, as we are having only one memory location, only one member can be accessed at a time. It's very clear. Here all the elements can be stored simultaneously, so everything can be accessible. But here only one member at a time, so only one can be accessible. Okay. Now, next point is several members of a structure can be initialized at once. That means all these like roll number, name, mark, etc. can be initialized together. Because we can assign different values for all these different elements. It is also related to the previous point, but in the case of union, at a time we can have, or normally only the first member can be initialized. Only the first member can be initialized, because only one can be given a memory. Then later onwards only the other members can be given. If we assign some other data, some other element, then the first one will be removed from the memory. Then similarly, size of the structure is equal to, so the first point, the size of the structure is equal to the sum of size of each member. The total size of this structure is the, so if it is an integer, it will be having 2 bytes. If it is a char, it is 1. If it is a float, it is of 4. If it is an integer, 2. So this sum will be selected as the total size of a structure. But in the case of union, the size of the union is equal to the size of the largest member. So 5 members are there. Among that, the largest member, what is the size? If it is 4, that is the maximum size allotted for storing any union member. So these are the differences between the concept structure and union. So commonly we are using structure because normally we require different data together, and we need to have some processing on all these elements. But union, that is difficult, so it is not being used regularly. So it's a very important point, the difference between structure and union. So all these are actually related. Two major points: the difference in creation means the usage of different keyword, and then the memory allocation is the major difference that happens between the structure and union. Okay, now let us see some examples. First of all, I'll take one example. We'll see the difference among structure and union here with a simple example. In this program, first of all, I'll be creating a structure person. Inside this structure, we are having char pin code. So this is a character array. Okay, so char pin code. So character is of 1 byte. So total size is 6 byte. I have simply given as a comment here. Then age, which is having 4 bytes. So here I have taken 4 because it is using a different architecture. Normally, 32-bit system it will be having 2 bytes. Okay, so don't confuse on that. Here it is given as 4. Okay, so if in your system if it is 2, it is 2. Okay, double salary. Double means it is 8 bytes. Okay, that depends on the system architecture only. This size will be decided. That already you are familiar, right? You'll be knowing that because depending on the system architecture also the size will be decided. Now a structure person with a pin code, age and salary is being created. Okay, so assume that these are the sizes for individual elements. First one 6, this is 4 and this is 8. We'll take this one itself. Okay, now just after that I'll be creating a union. Let us see the union employee. There also I am having char pin code, age and salary. So here also you can say for pin code will be having the size 6, for age will be having the size 4, and double will be having the size 8. Okay, so one structure and one union, two different record user defined data type has been created. One is by using structure and second one is by using union. Okay, now let us look into the main program where we are creating the variables for these two. So first of all, I am creating a variable p of type struct person. So one person is being created here. Then an employee e is being created based on union employee. So by using these two types, I am creating two variables. Okay, so P is having the properties of person, E is having the properties of employee. Now I am trying to print the size of person, size of P. Size of P means this P. That means person P. So what is the size there? So structure, this total size will be the sum of size of all the elements. That means 6 plus 4 plus 8. What is that? 18 will be printed here. 18 will be printed. So similarly, size of union, here size of E. Size of E means here the employee variable, that is depending on the union employee. So what is this? What is the property of union? The largest element size will be taken for the size of union. So the largest is double and that is 8. Okay, so total size allocated for structure is 18. It is of larger size. For union, it is of smaller. That is only 8 byte. Okay, now, so this is the sample output. Size of structure person is 18 and size of union, that is 8. Okay, so just a comparison between structure and union. Basic difference between structure and union. Now, we'll take one more example where we'll see I am creating it is exclusively used with the union data. It consists of one integer I, float f, then char str of 20. So one integer value, one float value, one string. So union is being declared, I mean that structure is being created. Then within the main I'll be creating a union variable. That means this is small letter data, capital D data. So this is the union name, and I am declaring a variable data, small letter data. Okay, so this is the union variable that is being created based on this union data structure, data type. Okay, so now I'll be assigning data.i is equal to, so how we are accessing the member, similar to structure here also we are using the same that is by using the dot operator we are accessing the member. So data.i, so I'll be assigning the first value i is equal to 10. I am assigning that. Okay, we'll see what will happen. Data.f I am assigning 220.5, then I am assigning into this str20. Okay, so it is a string variable, so I am using strcp, that's why I was including string.h. I am using strcpy, where into data.str I am copying a string. Okay, this string is being copied into the str string. Okay, so we have given three initialization into a union variable, that is this data. Now I am trying to print data.i I will be printing, data.f I will be printing, data.str I will be printing. Okay, now what is the problem here? We have already seen the difference with structure, that only one element of a union can be processed at a time. At a time we can have access to only one, that means the memory is allocated for only one element. Okay, so here I am trying to assign 10 220.5 and C programming, so we are having only one memory location but three things are being assigned. So which value will be printed here, whether these three will be printed? No, that will never happen. And what is the result of this one? What is this? Now we are having a printf statement, data.i, here some value is being printed. What is this? Some value will be printed. What is this? We don't know what is this, right? This can be called as a garbage value. Okay, so some garbage value will be printed in the place of data.i. Okay, then data.f, some other garbage value will be printed. Now data.str, what will happen? That means whatever value is assigned into that union at the end, that will be displayed normally. All other print will be printing some garbage value. So that memory location will be having that union can have only the recent assigned value. So C programming, that value is available here. All other values that are already assigned, so some value will be printed when we are mentioning this data.i. So some system, for some compiler it will display an error, for some compiler it will display a garbage value. So we don't know what is this value, right? So only this is the permitted value. So it is very clear that we can do initialization, but only one will be initialized. We have done these three, but only one is initialized. Which one? The last one. Okay, so first one it was initialized, but after that it was replaced with this one, then it was replaced with this one. Now what is there in the union? Only this one. So we are trying to print these three, so others will be filled with garbage value. Okay, so the problem when we are using union variable. Okay, so the basic advantage is we can use different types here, but when we are dealing with memory allocation, assignment and all, it creates problem. Let us see a modification on this program. If you want to display all the three for the same program, if you want to display all the three, what we can do? I have a modification on the same program. I have created union with the same value i, f and str20. Then I am having the main. I have created a union variable data. Then I have assigned data.i is equal to 10. Data.i is equal to 10. And into this, we are trying to print this data.i. Printf data.i, I will be trying to print data.i. So while assigning the value itself, I am trying to print the value of data.i. Okay, so what will happen is, before overwriting this union memory location, so I have written 10 here. This is the union memory. I have written 10 here. Then I am printing that, so 10 will be displayed. Okay, then I am assigning 220.5, so it will be replaced with 220.5. Then I am trying to print 220.5, so this will be printed. Then I am copying C programming into data.str, so this will be replaced with C programming. That string will be added, and then I am trying to print C programming string. Okay, so if you want to display these three, if you want to process these data differently one by one, if you want to display that, you can go for this one. Okay, so separately just reading, assigning and printing, that is not the actual requirement. No, normally we need to have simultaneous process on all these data. Okay, so let us see the sample output of the program. Data.i is equal to 10. So because while assigning and printing that, data.f, the value that is being entered, that is 220.5, that will be printed. Then I am assigning C programming, that will be printed. But at this point also, if we want to refer the union, it will be having only the value C programming. All these values are already being removed. So the maximum memory being allocated for a union variable is the largest element. That is the maximum size that is permitted, but only one element at a, so when it is having the I, only I can be held there. When it is having F, only F can be held there. When it is having str, only str can be held in this particular union variable. Okay, so just a similar concept of user defined data type by using union variable, by using union keyword, we can create a structure like data type with different types of built-in data types, and along with that we can have the creation of union variables, but it is having the problem of sharing the memory. At a time only one element can be held in the memory of union variable. So similarly, we can create many number of union variables. For each union variable, only one memory will be allocated, and that memory can hold any one element belongs to that particular union variable. Okay, so for this this session was actually for a comparison of union with structure, and basically by having the comparison with the memory allocation and how to use the union keyword and how to create a union like record type architecture. Okay, thank you.